Hello, YouTube and Facebook and Twitter and all social media fan bloggers. This is my visual dramatization of sleep paralysis, aka old hag syndrome, aka soul slimacker. There have been previous videos that I've uploaded about sleep paralysis, but I talked about the medical research that was going on in Mass General Hospital in Massachusetts as we spoke that day, because I came from there. I was gathering information for my sleep paralysis research assignment at the time. That was like 2 years ago. And now I got to do a visual dramatization of sleep paralysis. As you can see, there's the ugly unicorn hag with a pig snout and tiny razor-like teeth sucking the air out of this poor old man. His name is Dakin. We are going to write down his name. He is an Ethiopian name, as you can see, from ancient Eritrea. Dakin Kazina. Yes. That is Dakin, or Dakin, however you want to pronounce it. His name is Dakin Kazina. Name originates from ancient Eritrea / Ethiopia. And everything else is all that cool stuff, man. So, sleep paralysis. The paranormal explanation of sleep paralysis is based off of an old myth of old hag syndrome. I'm sure everyone has heard of that. You ever had that feeling one night when you're sleeping on your back and you can't move, and then your breathing becomes restricted for some reason? And then you get these scary hallucinations of horrible, unhumanly things prowling over you, just hovering over you while you are physically impaired for the next 3 minutes of sleep paralysis. And then this ugly little hobbit thing comes and it sits right on your chest and it represses your breathing, and there's like a mist that comes out of its mouth and it sucks out all of your breath from your body, leaving you lifeless, and your heart is pounding under your ribs and you could barely move or breathe. Better yet, all you could do is move your eyes left and right. You can't move them up and down. You can't scream for help. Your mouth has been soul slapped by the invisible hand of sleep paralysis / old hag syndrome, aka soul slapper. That's the mythical part of sleep paralysis. Some people have even claimed that the entities of sleep paralysis have actually attempted to have sex with them. Okay, now, I believe these people are just after attention. I do not believe that no crazy critter with both male and female genitals would want to have sex with a human being while they're sleeping and paralyzed. The medical part of sleep paralysis is your brain being stuck in between the stages of rapid eye movement and your sleep. There's a fluid that circulates around the brain that goes down into the spinal cord, disabling your physical movement, leaving you paralyzed for approximately 3 minutes. If you've been paralyzed, well, if you've experienced sleep paralysis for longer than 3 minutes, you have another problem. There's something else happening while you're asleep. Sleep paralysis is associated with those who have epilepsy, narcolepsy, and social anxiety issues. Unfortunately, sleep paralysis only happens mostly within the community of African Americans. But otherwise, it generates mostly around men. At a normal basis, humans such as females, kids, and everything don't really get sleep paralysis that much. I've had sleep paralysis before, and it was terrifying because I couldn't breathe. What I usually do is, in order to break the cycle of sleep paralysis, is you try to, you can't move, you just really can't move. It's like you're being sucked out of all of your energy completely. But I never actually have the hallucinations. I don't see anything there. It's just that my physical body is not able to move. And your eyes just become so heavy that you can't keep them open for long. And they just snap shut, which is kind of crazy. It's a scary feeling at first, but after a while of having sleep paralysis, the best thing I just continue to do so that I don't lose breath is to try as hard as I can to take in as many deep breaths as possible. Because if, when you run out of breath, it seems like 3 minutes feels like three centuries long. It is the longest 3 minutes of sleep paralysis ever. However, the worst thing to do in order to get sleep paralysis is sleep on your back. That's when it's more likely to attack you. Your chest and everything is opened. And laying down kind of makes it difficult to breathe on your back. So sleeping on your sides and your stomach make it less likely for sleep paralysis attacks to happen. And you can have a look at my visual dramatization.